How about you connect these LoRaWAN sensors that Eric is holding right now, so one sensor, one gateway right now, how about you integrate that into Power Apps in a matter of seconds? That's what Eric came to the IoT show today to show us. Hi everyone, thanks for watching the IoT show. I'm Olivier, your host. What if I told you that there's an easy way to get IoT devices data into Power Apps and other Power Platform tools? This is exactly what Eric is here to tell us about with a great solution from his company that is called Power IoT. Eric, how are you?
Hey, great, great, Olivier. I'm so excited to be here. You know, I'm huge fan of IoT show, so it's a really an honor to be with you today.
Well, now you're on the show. You're one of the stars as well. Awesome. So tell us a bit about yourself. Who are you? Who is Eric? And what's the company that you are working for or with or created and that is bringing us the IoT data into Power Platform, sorry.
Okay, so I'm Eric Szymkowiak. So I'm a French guy now living in Montreal, Canada, and I'm CEO of PowerIoT. So at PowerIoT, we basically build a connected application for our customers. So we use sensors and we build amazing solution for them.
Awesome. So you're here to tell us about Power IoT, but before we get into what Power IoT is about and how it works and a little nice demo that you prepared for us. So what are the common top customer issues that you've seen, or problems, or you know, skills limitations, or whatnot, that you've seen the customers expressing that motivated you to work into that integration of IoT into Power Platform?
Yeah, very. It's a great question, Olivier. We, as you know, we build solution for our customers, so we've seen a lot of issue for IoT. So you see, I believe we all agree with these main issues, so that's complexity. We believe IoT is complex for because it takes people having a networking and software skill together to build a solution. Mm-hmm. And as a software developer, you have to learn networking technology, and that's not your job. So to tackle this complexity, we decided to provide a software component, so in Power Apps, to get sensor business data right away. So when I mean business data, I mean temperature value. So you can use this temperature value from the sensor, from the sensor directly in your application.
Okay.
Microsoft Power Apps is a low-code solution, and that gives result very quickly. So it tackles the two other issues we see in IoT. So the POC stopper, so we are not stuck in the proof of concept with Power Apps because we have result very quickly. And since it's quick, we don't have long time return on investment. So we decided to build Power IoT using Power Apps. So developer could use our component and build application very quickly. So we believe there is it opens up an amazing opportunity for developers.
Yeah, I agree. I seen your demo. Actually, I was struck by the fact that if you're an IoT developer used to devices, you know, the world of apps and visualization and so on is not that easy. And for people who are used to develop these kind of apps, IoT is kind of cryptic and black box, and you're kind of like scared to start working with that. So that's definitely something that you're combining or reuniting the two words that are pretty interesting here. And you were saying that like Power Apps simplifies app development, and so that's a natural choice here. You had a diagram that you brought up actually that kind of shows what Power IoT is and how it's built. So show us that and walk us through.
Yes, perfect. I don't want to make it complex. So in a nutshell, we have Power IoT, which has two parts: a server part, which is running on your Azure tenant, and a connector, which you are using in your Power Apps. We also provide components, but I will show that later on during the demo. Okay, and also you need sensor, right? So we are using LP1 technology, that stands for low power wide area network, And this is a new kind of technology that is very useful to connect sensor with long distance coverage. Power IoT is using LoRaWAN technology, which is very famous right now. And we partner with a manufacturer called Kerlink to offer a seamless integration. Mm-hmm. So all you need is this piece of hardware.
Yeah, so
which is
let's
a gateway.
See, yeah. Nice. It's pretty small actually, right?
Yeah, it's very small. This is the reason I will show you, because you see my hand, it's very small. It's a new product that they just launched out. Mm-hmm. And it's using cellular or Ethernet as a backhaul. And this single gateway in a building could collect messages from two floors, having like 10 flats or 10 apartments in each floor. So it's very long range coverage.
Yep.
Okay. And it's plug and play. So you just forward it and you can use it right away. And data will flow right away into Power IoT, and you can use it directly in your Power apps.
Yep.
So
and so
it's so very.
Some people are familiar with LoRaWAN and how it works. Some people are not. But we won't spend too much time here explaining what it is.
Yeah,
we have other shows
exactly.
about it. But it's very interesting, that notion of plug and play, because it's from the sensor all the way up to having the data in the back end in the cloud that it's plug and play, actually. You just plug that
exactly.
gateway in. The devices themselves, the LoRa devices, you just turn them on as well. They usually run on batteries, low power, and it kind of just works. It's pretty magic.
Exactly. This is the reason we select this product, because we would like to have this seamless integration.
Yep. And so that seamless integration for now is using the Kerlink LoRaWAN gateway that Power IoT knows how to work with. So tell me now, what's the, we see the architecture is pretty clear, and we'll see the demo in a second. It's going to be even clearer. How do people get started?
Okay. So if you're familiar with Azure, it's very easy. You just look for Power IoT into the Azure marketplace,
mm-hmm.
and it's a video. And you push on that button, get
okay.
it now. You just have to fill your country, your phone number, and then you push on continue, and that's it. And what it does is that it will copy the managed application into your tenant. So you must have an Azure account, and you must have at least one LoRaWAN gateway to start using Power IoT.
Okay. And I guess you can have several ones, right?
Yeah, of course. And the result would be these three resources in your tenant. So
okay.
Again, you don't have to deal with it, but just for the technical guys, they will see these resources in the tenant.
Okay. That makes sense. It's pretty straightforward. You just had to click that link on the marketplace, and it has been deploying the services that, as we're saying, for people who want to understand what's going on, basically there's an LNS in there, a LoRa network server that is part of Power IoT, and Power IoT will also take into, its role will be to get the data from the LNS and to translate the packets that is receiving into something that is consumable in Power apps, right?
Yeah, this is the next slide as well.
There you go. I'm in advance.
Yeah. We have this teeny and small device we will use for the demo. It's a MySight device, and it's battery powered. It measures CO2, so you know mm-hmm. CO2 is very important right now.
Okay.
And so with the e-link screen, it could last many years. So you can get the info directly on the screen, and we will demonstrate how to get it into your application.
Okay.
So you're right, but you have to consider that all the sensors, they don't send CO2 equal, I don't know, 1,000 ppm. They send like a message like this.
Yep.
And the beauty of Power IoT is that it will, because we know this product, it will convert this product into measurement. So data, business data, you can use directly in your apps. So for you as a developer, you say, well, give me CO2 measurement and that's it.
Yeah, and it's nice that you're showing the actual packet or the actual body of the messages that LoRaWAN is sending because they do optimize for bandwidths all the way down to how many bits they're sending over the radio, right? And so that means that the data cannot be a nice JSON file that then you easily consume on the back end. And you have to decode the packets that are coming from that device.
Exactly. plus the security, plus everything that comes with LoRaWAN, but for you, it's completely transparent.
Yeah, exactly. Well, let's see it in action. So we have the architecture here, little sensor will connect to your Power IoT application that's been deployed on your subscription. Let's see it in action.
Okay, perfect. So just open up a simple Power IoT application. And in this application, we have basically four screens. Okay. So first screen is a device explorer. It's just a way to list all the sensors we register into Power IoT. So you can see the name, you can see the product. Remember, I explained why we need the product, and also the ID. So the ID is a unique identifier you will use to address the sensor. So it's very important. Mm-hmm. As you see, it's very easy to get the data from Power IoT. You just use the connector. You have some information, some calls like get things, and then you can list all the things that are registered. So everything is documented in the connector, which is public on Microsoft GitHub. But it's very easy to use, but we believe it's not so easy. So we would like to go further and really make it easy for you as a developer. So let me show you something else. Here on that screen, I inserted a picture of an office from my local drive. I get the ID of the sensor, okay? So the CO2 sensor. And now I would like to put this sensor here because I know this sensor is right here.
Okay.
So what I'm doing is that I'm just using this custom component. Remember, I told you, I explained that we build some custom component. So I'm clicking on this component, and boom, I have like a, we call it a sensor twin. I like to have a software image of the real sensor that is on the floor. Okay.
Okay.
So now suppose that now this sensor is not linked to the real sensor, right? So I have to provide, so here this is the component property, I have to provide the sensor ID. I press to update the value, you see, because here I have no value right now. Mm-hmm. And now you see on the tooltip, I have the value, so it's very bad.
Okay.
With more than 1,000 in my room, I should
not, good.
Not be able to talk anymore, but I mean...
Open your windows.
Yeah, I should... Okay, so, but you get the ID, okay?
Yeah.
So now, so again, you can just make it smaller, move it, etc. And here to show you how it's easy to get the CO2 in something else you would like to do, so an action, you just use the name of the resource, so my site, plus you address the value, which is the CO2. So remember, I talk about business measurement. This is it. Here, as a developer, you would like to use the CO2 from this sensor. You just address it like that and put it into your text. And now suppose you would like to say, well, I have these limits and I would like to have something bad happening when it's more than 1,000, and just change this value. And here,
yeah, the sad face appearing when the value goes above that threshold.
Very easy. You see, if the CO2 is more than the value that is in that field, just show it and that's it. But you can do whatever you want. You can use a Outlook connector and send you an email. You can also send a notification in Teams. I mean, you can imagine whatever you want.
Yeah, I think right now you can only... you know, leverage the all the power of Power Platform and integration to business applications.
Exactly.
The IoT data is just like seamlessly here as a variable, right? So that's pretty straightforward now.
Exactly.
So
and this is why you selected this title for the show. It's how we integrate sensors into Power Platform, and this is it.
Nice. So can you show me how this little component that is displaying the data in this little square he's done? Because that's an interesting part. I want to customize that. So how do I go about it?
So right now, it's this component is within my application, right?
Okay.
So it's like any component. We put a sensor image as well. And when you press this button, it's just getting the data from Power IoT. So the last measurement, okay, the time, etc. And then it's just populate this data as parameter, so you can use it outside of the component.
Mm-hmm.
So
pretty straightforward. But that's so
property, and that's it.
That's something that you, as a developer in Power Apps, have been building, right?
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. And this is something we give for free. I mean, on our GitHub, you can use this component.
Okay.
And just import it into your library or into your app, and then you have this component ready to go.
Nice. And so yeah, and we'll talk about this notion of like inviting the community to help build this collection of components.
Yeah.
Or because one person like you might want to have this kind of visualization for that sensor, but maybe someone else is using it in a different context and will want a different visualization. But then eventually you want to share it, right? And so we'll talk about that. But before going there, I wanted to ask you, so here you're playing with one sensor, right? That connects to a gateway. So and that means that Power IoT knows how to decode the data, the body of the messages, the packet is coming from the LoRa infrastructure into the cloud. So how many of these sensors does Power IoT support today?
Right now, we support more than 500 LoRaWAN sensors. So you have a lot of choice to do your application. And if we don't support the sensor you would like to use, we could add it very quickly. I mean, it's not a big deal.
Nice. And I guess this is a call for device manufacturers in the LoRaWAN world to say, hey, we are simplifying how the data is consumed in a Power application. And so come to us and we'll eventually add your sensors into our collection of supported sensors so that Power IoT can offer these sensors as plug and play devices into Power apps.
Exactly.
That's awesome. I love that. So actually, that leads us to back to that notion of community. So there's this notion of component, right, which is a visualization and how the sensors are seen here, which actually you also have a call for action here for developers who aren't in Power Apps for contributing their own version of these components for the various sensors that are already supporting Power IoT.
Yes, absolutely. As I mentioned, we already partner with a lot of manufacturers, including my site. And we have a lot of decoders. So the next step will be to help us build this component and also broadcast. I mean, share this component to the community because it will help to have better visualization and better components and it will be very useful for the community to build applications.
Nice. Perfect. Well, we'll bring up here a short link that is pointing to a blog post that sums up everything we've seen today and also has the various links to various resources. So we definitely invite you to go down there to this link, which is aka.ms/IoTshow/PowerIoT. And you will be able to find all the information that Eric just shared today. Eric, thanks a lot for coming to the show. I hope to see you again soon because I'm sure you guys will have more to share with us soon, right?
Et on pourra parler français.
Et on pourra le faire en français. Exactly. We wanted to do that. Awesome. Eric, thanks a lot for coming. Everyone, thanks for watching
the
show.
Thank you, Olivier.